Okay.
Battle of the Bands, Bands.
B-O-T-B.
Battle of
the Bands. With Kyle and Sam. What? B to the O, to the T, to the B.
Edge Sense. Cool. Welcome to the episode. This is going to be one of the best episodes ever.
I can feel it. There's energy in the air. We're smiling our asses off.
Fuck my ass. Yeah. This is going to be one of the greatest episodes of all time. It's 10 o'clock at night.
Yes. And let me just say this.
What?
This is Battle of the Bands with Kyle and Sam. I'm Kyle.
Yeah.
That's Sam.
Yeah.
And we're here to make you change.
Change? Pardon?
We're here to make you change, brother.
Yes, because we're not only podcasters and music aficionados, we're also life coaches. We want you to change.
Yes, we don't want you to be what you are right now.
No, because you're boring and no one like you.
Yeah,
they don't. Seriously, your mama called me. She said I don't like her.
You're probably thinking, oh, I have all these intrusive thoughts. Does everyone hate me? Does everyone think I'm a piece of shit? Honey, newsflash. This just came in. Yeah.
Yeah, yeah.
You're a fucking piece of shit.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Quick question. Sorry to end the bit.
Go ahead.
Intrusive thoughts. What that?
It's thoughts that are negative a lot of the time.
Isn't that just thoughts?
About you?
Yep.
No.
Is that not just thinking?
Intrusive thoughts, a lot of them, it happens with people with OCD a lot of the time.
Oh, intrusive is like, my house is going to burn down.
Something along the lines of when you hold a baby and you have an intrusive thought, I want to throw this baby on the ground.
Oh, I think that all the
That's
time.
That's normal.
Yeah.
Well, but there's...
David, I think we're learning something.
It's okay
about
that
you.
We're naming... The thoughts have a name. They're called intrusive thoughts.
No, you can't. They just apply names to things that are normal, and they give them like this medical.
For you, they're normal thoughts.
For everyone,
like if you're holding a knife, you're like, "What if I threw the knife into my head?"
Yeah,
not necessarily that, but you might think, "What if I threw the knife across the?" You just think like, "What if?"
It
crosses your mind for a millisecond, but it's
and gone. That's an intrusive thought.
And that's totally normal.
But isn't any thought? But then, what if you're like, "What if I just ate a thing of ice cream right now?" Is that not an intrusive thought as well?
Because
they're thoughts that you can't control.
Yeah,
is that what it is?
A conscious and a subconscious, and the subconscious obviously works without.
And of course, David AI, because you're AI, can you please search that up on your little system that you have?
Search
your brain.
System. What intrusive. Is intrusive thoughts? And is it always negative? Because that aren't.
I believe intrusive
I feel like
thoughts are negative.
Aren't all thoughts intrusive?
I think it has to do with OCD.
Okay. Okay. Okay, I'll take your word for it.
An intrusive thought is an unwelcome, involuntary thought.
Unwelcome.
But it's involuntary because...
I feel like all thoughts are unwelcomed, right?
Yeah.
I'm not like, I'm about to think of this. It just pops in my head.
Unwelcome as in you don't like it.
Oh, okay. Yeah. I don't like it. That's most of my thoughts.
Well, that's because
Sam,
you have a serious
normal.
Problem.
You're healthy.
Huh?
You're
not... No, do not lie to Sam.
Well, you know,
Sam,
I'm not.
I know
healthy. That. I know that, David. I'm not all there. I'm not wired properly. I know that. No, I know that.
Baby,
but you know
you're
what?
Perfect.
Thank you. Mm. And because my brain don't work properly, it mean I funny. It mean I'm a funny one.
Oh, God, you picked me. I'm a funny one.
Yes, I have negative thoughts all day, but we know what that mean? I can riff.
Howdy doody daddy.
About 2 hours while I lay in bed, I think about where we go after life.
Absolutely.
I'm funny, bitch.
Almost all day, I think, what's the point of literally doing anything in life? We're all going to die. And then I go, hey, yes, and I can do a scene. I can riff. I can do whatever, whenever.
Sometimes I think to myself, maybe I'm in the subway or maybe I'm walking home and it's nighttime. I think, will I ever be truly loved by anyone in the world or am I just evil inside? Mm-hmm. And because of those thoughts, I have a comedy album.
Yes.
Life is good on Easy Street.
Yes. We have the perfect combination of having negative thoughts and a really bad outlook on ourselves. But also, we really, really want the, the acceptance of others, too.
Yes.
Which is what make you funny on stage. Is what make you get on stage and go, how are my daddy? How are my darling? How am I loving too? Do you like me?
Every day I thank God that I'm a small, wienered, loud man. What a combination. And that lets me be Showtime. Yes. I'm a small wienered loud man.
Small wienered loud man.
Wienered.
Wienered. Yes. Small wienered loud. Weird. Say that three times fast. Well, me, I am a spineless, zero direction, zero plan in life, motherfucker, and I really don't see what others see in me. Yes. So, but baby, I can write a joke sometimes.
Yes. I am a sad, pathetic, late little worm. When people ask me, Kyle, what's your 5-year plan? I go, so and so, and then I'm in the ground for 4 years.
4 years? You're in the ground for 4 years?
I died after a year.
Oh, okay. Then why are you in the ground for 4 years?
Because I'm dead.
You're in the ground for 4 years.
Of my 5-year plan.
Oh,
the last
okay.
4 years, I'm in the ground.
And then onwards.
And then forever.
Yeah, yeah, forever. That. Okay. Then like after 4 years, they like dig you up and then they move you.
Oh, and then I get reborn.
Like a contract.
Zombie Kyle.
Zombie Kyle.
I don't eat brains. I eat
pussy.
Ass.
Yeah. Oh. See, this is why we're funny.
Yes, very good. And I'm happy to be here. And I'm sure that everyone here in the room with me is happy to be here, including David AI.
Yeah, buddy.
Yep, guys.
Yep.
David, you killed it, brother. You're killing it.
But yeah, like we've started off already. What are we, a couple minutes in? We're already talking about intrusive thoughts, how we feel about ourselves.
The best podcast, I feel like, come from when we started off.
This is going to be the best podcast, I can feel
it. Yeah, we're happy. It's very, very good. We're going to have great moments all the way through.
And all the way through. Well, last week's episode.
Yes.
Kyle brought R. Kelly. Mm-hmm. And after we recorded, we went up, and I told Kyle about Trapped in the Closet.
Yes.
The R. Kelly, kind of, what would you call it? Opera? Yeah. Soap opera?
Yes. It's basically a soap opera, a musical soap opera.
Yeah, it's like eight or ten parts or something like that. Yeah. It's great. And, we were really enjoying it. We had to stop it halfway because we had to do another episode. Duty calls.
Can you believe that Trapped in the Closet probably has a laugh a minute?
It's one of the funniest things I've ever seen. Yeah. It's great. It's so good.
He's a genius.
Yeah.
Well, tortured.
Tortured genius.
Torturer.
Torturer genius. Yeah. Yeah, sure. but we thought, what if we did our own version?
Yes.
A Battle of the Bands Trapped in the Closet.
Yes.
Yeah.
Very cool.
And so this is going to be a little segment. What should it be called? Trapped in the Podcast Studio.
Trapped in the Studio.
Trapped in the Studio. Okay. I like this.
All right, very cool.
Okay. So you will start it. Maybe I'll kick it off.
Yeah, you kick it off.
Okay.
No. Hey. I open my eyes, it's 10 in the morning, I'm in the studio again. Look at the window, it's raining, I'm wondering where are my friends. Where's Kyle? Where's David? What am I doing here? Oh my God, I look to my left, I see an open beer. I haven't gone to bed yet, I've been clubbing all night. I brought a girl home, don't even know her name yet. Then I say, hey, baby, what's your name again? She pulls down her pants. She's got a big old dick. Oh, no, the girl's a guy. Didn't mean to bring a guy home last night.
Just wait. Don't go away just yet. If you let me stick it in, I'm sure I can get you wet.
Oh no, oh my, oh geez, oh no, it's a guy, gotta go, gotta go. I open my phone and I call Kyle, ring ring. Yo, what you doing right now? I'm just hanging out with my hoe. Okay, something just happened. I brought an old lady to the studio. Is she on the pod? She said, yes, I guess so. But I took her pants down and she had a weenie and I don't know what to do. Oh my God, man, take her out the stew. Okay, and I took her by the hand. I said, baby, I love you, but you gotta go, gotta go. She said, I gotta tell you something. I said, what? Make it quick, we gotta go. She looked me in the eyes and she said, that's not a dick, it's a clit.
that's part one.
That's part one that's of part In one. The Studio.
Oh,
very cool.
You know what? Fun.
It's fun.
That kind of went better than I thought.
Yeah.
Yes.
Once you start, you can kind of like find the... You can find the rhythm.
You can find a thing, and the thing about Trapped in the Closet is it's full of twists.
It's full of twists. Yeah.
M. Night Shyamalan-style twists.
Well, do we start our own? Each episode, we do a second part.
Next week, Kyle kicks it off.
Trapped in the Studio.
Yeah, Trapped in the Studio.
Wake up. I look left. There's an open beer. I don't know. What did I do? I called my Kyle.
That was good. You were good. You had a great part there, too.
That was great.
Yeah, that was fun. That was fun. Okay, then I guess next week we'll do part two. Follow the story.
We do Trapped in the Studio.
So right now I hooked up with a
woman who you thought was a man,
but then has a big clit. That's the twist.
And she's a guest on the pod.
And she's a guest on the pod. Okay.
Oh no, you gotta get her out the stew. Ring ring.
Hey Kyle.
Yo.
I'm just with my hoe.
It's a perfect. It's perfect.
It's great. It's really good.
What a way to do music.
And you know what? And he's an evil person, and we're taking it back. We're taking back the Trapped in the Closet.
Yes, that's what you can do to these people that are evil.
Yes.
If they make good stuff, you can take their stuff and make it your own.
Yes.
And then he has nothing.
He has nothing.
Except gigabytes and gigabytes of, I assume, child pornography.
And probably crazy, crazy little memories of things. All he has is horrific memories. Well, I guess not horrific for him.
Well, but yeah.
Well, let's not go down this road again.
When he goes to the gates of St. Peter, I'm sure he will get what comes.
What comes? Come what may.
What's coming? I'm at the gates.
St. Peter, let me in.
Let me
in. Why you leave me out here?
And he's like, yo, what you did? That wasn't that cool.
He also loves repeating the word. He's like, she says, don't go to the door. I say, go to the door. She says, I can't go to the door.
Maybe, David, is there anything new with you?
No, still grabbing my...
Yeah, your hand is in your pocket. Yeah.
Dude, these fucking shorts, the pockets are huge, which I love, but they make my hand go like right literally down the middle of my crotch.
Right. It looks like
and
you're...
And I have keys, so I'm jingling, right? So,
yeah. It looks crazy.
And could I say that even though your pockets are big like that, it does not mean you have to touch your penis?
No.
I couldn't touch my penis. Dude, there's fabric over my penis. I wouldn't be touching them.
Well, we don't know that.
Obviously, we don't know that.
We don't know that.
You do know that.
This actually does remind me of an invention I made.
What?
They're adult diapers. Good. Have I told you this?
You might have.
This is diapers for guys.
Diaper for guys.
For dudes.
Okay.
And they're
dude
adult
diapers.
They're dude diapers, and they're diapers that when you go into the bathroom in them, all of the waste goes towards your crotch, so the more you go bathroom, the bigger your penis looks.
Nice. I like that a lot.
Yes, the bulge.
Dude diapers.
Dude diapers.
I like dude diapers.
Thank you.
Yeah.
So maybe, listeners, if you want to make that and send that to me.
Master Bastard, if you can get on there.
Master Bastard, if you could get AI to create.
3D print dude diapers. That'd be perfect.
Yeah. Anything new with you?
If you have a perfect shit too, like a long one, it would just come around and then it looked like weenie.
And two.
It looked like weenie.
And we'll move on.
And we'll move on.
It'd be great to have a healthy bowel movement.
Huh?
I said it'd be great to have a healthy bowel movement.
Yeah, it's been a while for me.
What? Okay, we don't have to go. We did poop episode a couple episodes ago.
Did we?
Yeah, we talked for poop for hours.
Ah.
What?
I love it.
No, you don't.
I love talking about that shit. Yeah, I don't know. What else do we want to talk about?
Yeah, what new with you?
Nothing really. You know me. You know me. What new with you? Wow. I don't think we've ever like hit a wall this hard before.
Well, no. I think it's because it's 10. What about you, David?
It's 10. It's
is
late.
Anything?
Went on a couple dates.
What?
Oh, this is great.
Finally. Here David, why are you... Yeah. What's it called? Burying the lead.
Burying the lead, yes. Yeah.
Buddy.
Went on some dates.
Congrats.
Thank you. I have a hard time... I seem so confident in the first interaction, getting the number, getting everything, and then come the date, I just turn into, and if just not to whatever, but like effeminate, like girl, just like total friend vibes I give off.
Really?
There's no like romantic
tension of any kind.
Yeah,
so I've just been getting fucking shot down by literally the hottest girls. I've ever had the opportunity to go out with.
Okay.
Not giving me anything after the first.
Well, my first question, where'd you meet the, how many girls is this? Two?
Three.
Three? Oh, David. Jesus Christ.
I mean, this is.
You're doing it all like in person or is this all Tinder or online?
No, in person. Which also, is great. I want to say there's no like real difference.
That's scary.
You're going up to them?
Yeah.
That's very scary.
And so I guess my question is, between the time you scare them and the time you're saying hello, what do you do?
Dude, that's the thing, because it usually is scary.
Yeah.
I don't know.
It's terrifying.
Yeah. It really is.
Hi, how you doing? How you doing?
Bro, because I feel like no girls in this city, for the most part, like really like look at you. Like, because you need that look to be like, okay, this is happening. Yes. I need to pursue. But like,
I think that's them trying to protect themselves in public.
Well, sure.
Because if they look at a guy and he's like, hey, how you doing?
I get that. I understand that.
You know what's great?
I would eat you.
Is a friend.
I know.
It's like, that's always a great thing, like going to like a barbecue or something. Yeah. And then you hit it off with someone at the barbecue. You know what I mean?
Yes.
Or like, oh, my friend's visiting from out of town. And then they bring you along, right?
Yeah.
And then you're you're part of the group already. And then there's a lady, you hit it off and...
Absolutely. Yeah. And I'd be down for that. But usually, let's say in this hypothetical barbecue, it's run by a comic. And for some reason in my head, I've told myself I don't want anything to do with any girl attached to comedy. Even if it's like...
Even if she's not a comic?
Honestly,
say don't date comic.
Honestly, kind of. Yeah. Like if they have any... I get a bit nervous if they have any sort of connection to a comedian.
Really?
I get a bit like... Interesting. If this goes wrong, it's a mess. It's like... I feel it dying.
I see where you're coming from with
that. I feel that sentiment dying.
Yeah.
But it's definitely still there.
Yeah.
It was strong when I first started.
Yeah. I could see that. Comic though, you just don't do it.
I mean, you guys just don't have do both it. Experienced that.
Sure.
Yeah. It's good. It's good. Everything's good. I'm lucky. I'm one of the lucky ones.
It ended well or ended well enough?
Ended well. Ended well, yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
I'm still friends.
Still friends.
Yeah.
I see them. It's cool. Yeah.
Yeah. It's more than cool.
Yeah.
Good.
Yeah. It's very good. But then, you know, we know some people where if it ends bad, is awkward.
It could be rough.
It is awkward and tense.
Have you guys had to pick sides?
No, I've never had to pick sides. No. Thank God. Don't want to.
Old enough to not have to.
Yeah. I'm not picking sides. Yeah.
But even in like... Now you're old enough, fair enough. But even when you're in your mid-20s, early 20s, because you've been doing comedy for fucking long.
No. Sure. No.
Yeah.
The people that I'm thinking of, it's they were mature enough to not be like, it's team me or team them.
Yeah, why are you booking him?
They didn't do that. So that was like, yeah, people who do that, I'm like, I mean, I guess it depends on the situation, but it's when you're just like, You're with me, or if you talk to them, like, we're done.
Yeah.
It's like, okay. But I'm lucky. I'd never had to deal with it.
What are these dates you're going on? Say that. What's the last date you went on? You went for coffee? You went for a drink?
Yeah, always been, these past three, it's been a dumb move, but coffee.
Why is that dumb move?
Because...
What? You agree?
I think that might be dumb move.
Why? Yeah. What's wrong with that? I'm
is
curious.
It daytime?
Daytime,
coffee. I think that's... There's no romance in a daytime coffee.
Well, it's a first date.
Your next, I think you should raise the stakes a little bit.
Go for dinner.
The night raises the stakes.
Have you thought about
summertime? Nighttime.
Summertime, nighttime. Top of CN Tower restaurant.
Yes.
I think
Skywalk on CN Tower.
The roof of the Rivoli.
Yes.
I'm not an expert in dating by any means, but I think really the darkness and drinks is usually enough.
And we will not call it the darkness no more.
You both look at each other.
The darkness.
But daytime, I think, unless you're friends before and you have like a chemistry before that coffee date, I think daytime nothing's going to bring anything.
I mean, chances are, you're not. I can't imagine much will happen.
No help.
Physically. Yeah. At daytime.
Yeah.
I don't know. Daytime, though, is like, I want to see if we get along. And then you meet up at night to be like, let's see.
I guess.
What goes down.
I guess it should work that way.
But I think it should be more first date, nighttime, the darkness. Yeah. Let it pour over every single inch of the city.
Yeah.
Drinks. Or not even drinks. Hang out. walk.
Hang out.
Oh.
Near water. Nice.
Ice cream.
That's,
ice
cream. May I interject that? And those are great date ideas. But with one of the girls that I asked out, I proposed an idea to do something, and it was immediately shot down. And I've never had that before.
What did you propose?
I proposed like just hanging out, going to like an art gallery or some shit.
Art gallery. Okay.
She was like, "You're not going to an art gallery."
Yeah, I'm not. She's like, "I'm not into that stuff."
I'm not
like,
art gallery.
Like, I mean, who gives a fuck about the art? Just like to talk to a person and.
She's like, "Can I bring my scooter?" Because she was how she weighs.
Well, you know what? I kind of respect that.
Why?
Just being straight up, being like, I'm just not an art gallery person. I don't want to pretend I like art galleries.
Fair enough. I understand. Sure. I respect that as well for the being confident and being assertive. But for the sake of the first date, who really cares?
Who gives a shit? Yeah.
True. Yeah.
I mean, in my head.
You know what's nice? Sunset Park. Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Sunset, sun coming down. Like during the sunset, you're in a park. Maybe you have a cheese. Maybe you have a little.
No one does that. You've never done that.
Have you? I did that. Picnic with the first.
You've never done that.
Yes.
You've never done.
Yes,
that.
Yes, I did. But that's because I was dating someone during COVID time, so we had to go to the park.
On a first date, did you know the person before?
No, we talked on Hinge, and she became my girlfriend for over 2 years.
Oh.
You brought cheese to a park?
No, I cut the cheese at the park.
Yeah, you farted. You shit yourself. Yeah,
buddy.
Cheese whiz.
You're mad.
Mad, why?
Mad for no reason.
What?
You brought cheese to a park? Why the fuck would you do that?
Well, you just say things.
You should do what I do. Have 8 beers.
That's like your dinner party thing.
Yeah, oh, have
I
a dinner party.
At a dinner party?
Never been to a dinner party. Still haven't.
Really?
Yeah. No dinner parties for
our
me.
Our friend, we don't do it. Our friend group. We don't do dinner parties
at all. I dream of doing dinner parties. Dream of it.
Oh, David, you're so sweet. I want to just put you in a little box.
I'll punch you
in the nuts. I'd love to do a dinner party before I move. That would be nice.
Where do you move?
When do I move?
Oh, like from to your actual place. Yeah, I thought you were lying again.
Yeah. No.
Before I move to Alberta.
Before I move to... Yeah, I'm going to Edmonton.
Yeah. Yeah, you should. You should absolutely.
I should.
It'd be fun.
It would be fun. It would be.
I want to do a dinner, and everyone brings a dish.
Everyone brings a dish.
That'd be awesome.
I would love to do it just to see what you guys would bring.
I would bring scalloped potatoes.
Would you actually?
Yeah, that would make it be nice.
You would actually make something
or
here,
shepherd's pie of some kind. Yeah, yeah.
And then bring it over.
And it would be something where I bring it and I go, "You got to put it in the oven for 30 minutes."
Yeah.
And then we're good.
That's the plan. Yeah, totally. You would for sure bring like the dessert, baked goods. People don't know David AI, amazing baker.
You know what you could do? Bring a girl on a date, bring her to the dinner party that we're putting on, and then we get to wingman you.
Well, did you hear what almost happened one time?
What?
Oh, yeah.
David almost brought a first date to my birthday.
Yeah.
My birthday.
Wow.
Yeah.
David.
But because she was wondering how many people are there, she didn't want to come and it be like a small thing. Mm-hmm. And she stands out. So, and there was like 12.
It was
people.
The right move for her to not come.
Yeah. Amazing. I agree with that.
Yeah.
Well, I would love that. You know what? And I'd love to see what that would look like. Can we please do a scene? I will be David's date, first date.
Okay.
And you wingman David.
I wingman. I mean.
So you're you. Okay. Maybe it's your birthday. Maybe it's the dinner party.
Yeah, I'll say birthday.
David and I show up.
Okay, David. Is this the burger going to eat? Sorry, who are you?
He's your date.
I'm your first date.
At the dinner party.
Yeah. So you guys knock up my door.
Knock.
Let me in. I'm fucking hungry.
Just relax, please.
Okay. Sorry.
Sam.
Hello.
Hey, Sam.
Oh, hey, David.
Hey, do you fucking Sam?
Do I fucking Sam?
I'm sorry, Sam. Yeah. I had to bring her.
So what's up? What? Who is this?
This is Deborah.
Hi, Deborah. Mm-hmm. Hi. Well, yeah, come on in, guys.
Noticed anything?
Take your shoes. Well, Deborah, you don't have shoes. okay. Well, yeah, just come on in. If you don't mind wiping your feet, maybe before.
Can Deborah, Deborah needs to use your bathroom for a little bit.
Yeah, you might have to use your bathroom.
45 to an hour? Yeah, someone might be in there, but I will. Okay.
Deborah.
Sorry, Davey. By the way, I love you.
Oh.
You gross.
You guys are cute. How'd you guys meet?
I was cleaning the sewers one day, and she kind of came up behind me.
Yeah, in the sewer. That's where I live.
You live in the sewer?
Yeah.
Really?
She came up to me. He like, I love your style.
That's odd.
I didn't say that at all. I said, you're disgusting. Get away from me, you pig.
So, okay. Well, okay. Deborah.
Dave.
Deborah.
Hmm?
Don't take us the wrong way. What if we did a, it wasn't, I wasn't planning to have a outside party, but what if we maybe move this outside?
I would love that.
Just
because
it is.
Deborah?
There is a smell of sewage.
Deb, I thought you moved.
And now you moved.
Oh, hey, Kyle.
Hey, Sam. Hey, sorry. I just came through the back.
What? Do you guys know each other?
Do we know each other? Yeah, I used to date Deb.
Kyle and I used to go out for a long time.
You didn't tell me who did this.
Who is this?
Who's this?
Yeah, I don't know who this fucking guy is.
What? Well, I'm her boyfriend, Kyle.
Whoa.
Huh?
Put your hand down.
Sorry.
Wait, so now, David, you like Deborah now?
Yeah, wait, you do you like my ex just because she used to date me?
Oh my God, Deborah. No, 1 second ago, you were literally saying that you weren't even like me.
Deborah.
What's mine is mine.
You deserve better, girl. And by the way, here's a fish.
Oh, I love eating the fish too. I don't know the bones at.
Don't eat the fish.
Guys, can I just say this is my birthday and you're kind of making it about you?
Sorry, Sam.
Excuse
sorry.
Me, Sam.
Yeah?
It's Emma.
Hi. Yeah, what's up?
Have a good night.
She's leaving?
Going to bed.
Or you're leaving?
Going to bed.
Oh, you're going to bed?
Yeah, this is Travis, by the way.
Hi, Travis.
Hey, Travis, bye.
See you, Travis.
He's a nice dude.
Keep bringing characters, only me.
Oh, and then there's Donnie the motorcycle man.
Hey, how you doing?
Hey, Donnie!
Oh, you mind if I come in for a day?
Yeah, come in for a beer.
Thank you, man. Seriously, it's good to be here. Who's this little twerp?
Oh, and look who else is here. Johnny the clown.
Hey, Johnny, I love your work.
Ho-ho, thank you, guys. It's great to be here.
It's Johnny, and you brought your wife, Missy the Clown.
Yes.
Timmy the Clown. And your son, Bobo.
Bobo, you're a bitch.
Bobo, don't speak. Sorry. It's Kyle again.
Bobo don't speak.
And
I'm in trouble. D. Bobo don't speak. I'm in trouble. D. Wow. And we bow to the audience.
And we bow to the audience, and that was one of the worst performances personally
no,
by
actually,
me.
That
and
was good. Actually, that was really? Good.
Really?
Yeah. I don't like how I ended with calling Bobo a bitch. That was weak.
It was weak, yeah. It was easy. It was easy. It was easy.
Okay, right. You do it.
It was easy.
You do Bobo then.
Bop, bop, bop. Hello. See,
Bobo, he says bop, bop. Yeah. That's where you're wrong.
And you, sir, character's have to take Bobo. Improv class. Yes.
What? No, why can't I do voices? I do voices just as good as you guys.
Sure, okay.
All right,
do. Let's see you do a... Do you do celebrity impressions?
Yeah.
No.
Oh, okay.
I just do
you just do people. You just do characters.
Fake. Okay, a fisherman by the name of Axel.
Yes. Axel the fisherman.
Get on me, boat, you fucking waste you.
That wasn't bad, actually.
You waste you?
No, you waste you.
What's that?
I waste you.
You'll waste us.
Oh, I waste
you. And how long have you been on the sea?
Yeah.
I've been traversing this body of water for 6 months.
And could I just clarify, what body of water is that?
This is Lake Simcoe.
Okay.
Lake Simcoe.
You're a lake pirate. I like that.
Lake pirate. Cool.
Okay, not bad, David. I'll give you one more. Can I get a little girl named Tasha?
Tasha.
Hi, everyone.
Okay, and this is where his strength comes
yes.
out.
Yes. Oh, Tasha, you have tap shoes on.
I love to dance.
And okay. Tasha, just wondering, you're a young girl. Have you had your period
I
yet?
Knew you were going to do something like that.
I bleed red like the
Gentlemen.
And that, my friend, is...
Gentlemen.
All right.
I'm gushing right
now. No. We're done. We're done with this.
Tasha, but you sing as well, don't you?
I can do it all.
Okay.
Voice is changing.
Changing in a way I don't like.
Puberty is
Okay,
and you're a woman now, which we love, Tasha the woman.
Tasha the lady.
And do you sing, like, when you hear a guitar, you just start singing?
Give me a song. Any song with a guitar, I'll sing it.
Oh.
What a crazy cadence.
What about Michael Jackson, Beat It?
Just Beat It.
You know what, Tasha? What if you were, say, trapped in a closet?
What if you were trapped in the closet, Tasha?
What? And what would that sound like?
I want to hear your version of this. Let's hear it.
Gift me!
Okay.
Can I start?
Yeah, start whenever.
I'm in the closet. No, I'm not. I'm in the bathroom. I got my period for the first.
Just kidding. I
need to work on Tasha, but Tasha could be fun. Tasha could be fun.
Tasha could be fun.
Tasha could be fun. I could play with her.
Yeah, there's legs with that. There's potential
to be one of the best characters ever. Tasha, the period.
Yeah.
Well, you brought that up. That's my bad. Seriously.
I'm in the sewer.
Yeah.
I'm going to do, what was her name? Deborah?
Yeah. Deborah, yeah.
This is my friend.
Trapped in the sewer.
Yeah.
Okay. Here I go. All right. Waking up in the sewer, it's so stinky. I look to my left, I see Davy.
Hi.
Say hi.
Hello.
Then I grab his low little feet, tickle him a bit. Then I take him to my sewer rat neighbor. His name is the Tooth.
Hey, I'm the Tooth. Who do you have for me to eat?
It's me, Davy. My name is Davy, and I wear a muscle shirt, yeah.
Okay, Davy, no more speaking, please.
Aw, I like to talk, I like to sing as well.
Davy, your nipples are nice and close together.
Thank you, Tooth. Thank you so much. I love your rat nipples as well. You got six. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Yeah, that's six.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Oh, the sixth one on your back.
You got a lot of nipples all over your body, yeah.
Hey, Tooth, I gotta ask, have you paid rent yet?
You know, I'm using that money on more tits.
Tits, you got night tits. I like your tits.
Hey, Davy.
Tits, yeah.
Could you stop counting tits?
Can't stop counting tits. Can't stop. Up at my face. I see 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. I see 8.
Does the boy enjoy the beautiful tits on my back?
Wait, I'll pull down your pants. Two more tits.
Those are tits. Those are testes. I knew that from sex ed.
David, you know me so well. What are you?
Wait, he's not a rat. He's a mouse.
So he's a twist at the end.
He's a mouse with tumors.
He's a lab rat. I do like...
I can do that all day.
I know.
Trapped in the closet.
It's perfect.
That's just a fun thing to play with
it's
friends.
It's fun. You always end on a twist.
Yeah, but yeah, that's the rule.
The twist never has to be related that much to
Not
the
really.
Story.
Not really. Somebody, the twist could literally be a new character enters the room.
Yes.
Yeah. That's actually, that is most of the Art Gully thing.
Wait.
And then a man answered the phone.
That's so funny.
Yeah.
Yeah. So yeah. Anyway, great. You know what?
We've been listening to us
improvise songs, but I'd love to listen to a new local song.
Yes. So this week, and guys, please send in a local artist to me on Instagram.
What's your Insta?
FOGGIA__. Yeah. So this week we have I think he's from Brampton. He's a rapper, and his name is Raz Fresco.
Cool.
Amazing. What
I think
change.
Our first rapper.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yes. Yeah. And
very cool.
Is he a fan of the podcast?
No.
No.
And there's no
boycotted it actually.
And there's no worries there. Oh, he has 231,000 monthly listeners.
Yeah.
Amazing.
Those are like our numbers. Nice.
Yeah, amazing. Yeah.
Is there a certain song we should listen to?
Yes, Regrets.
Cool.
Regrets.
And you know what's funny? Maybe we should cut this out, but I'll say it anyways. I reached out to my ex, who is now dating a rapper, and I hit her up being like, hey, if your boyfriend wants a shout out on the podcast, I want anything weird.
Okay.
I would be welcome. Be a pleasure.
That's okay. Awesome.
And she said, no, would not be interested.
Okay.
What the hell?
Yes. So.
All right.
I'm offended.
No, it's because of of moi.
Oh, yeah, 100%. Yeah, yeah.
But there's no worries there. You've done nothing wrong.
Yeah.
I mean, what did you do other than love this woman with all your heart for as long as you did?
Are you guys on good terms?
We're on fine terms.
Fine enough that you messaged her.
Yeah. Yeah.
And you're like, what'd your boyfriend do? I would have a podcast and I'm going.
I hit her up and I was like, hey, your boyfriend wants some promotion?
Let's bury the hatchet.
Yeah.
Wow. David, that is huge of you.
Yeah, it is.
Is it?
Yeah. Selfless.
Buddy, I've done it. I've reached out and tried to bury the hatchet twice.
Yeah.
With this same person?
Same person. She's never apologized. Because she did her thing, too.
Sure, sure.
There's always two people to tangle.
Sure, sure.
From what I've learned from Trapped in the Closet, everyone has done something bad.
Everyone's done something bad.
Everyone is cheating on their spouse.
But I've apologized, so I don't know. I don't know what else to do. I don't really care, but...
Well, buddy, you got to move on. You have to just move on.
Yeah, David, there's...
And she also doesn't know you... I'm not saying this in a bad way. She also doesn't... You know, you can apologize, but she also doesn't have to accept your apology.
Oh, yeah. 100%.
And also, you don't have to accept hers.
Yes.
You know?
Yeah.
And the fact that you apologized and the fact that every day you are probably trying to better yourself or you're a different person every single day and you're making yourself better. And that's what...
Every single day, every hour.
Yeah.
I feel like a different person every hour of the day.
Every decision you make since that moment, if it's a better decision, you're a better person. And that's all you need to know.
There you go.
There you go.
And she's a bitch.
No.
And I'm going to fucking kill her.
Who's this again? What's the name of the rapper?
What's the name of the girl? Raz Fresco.
Raz Fresco. Cool.
Raz Fresco.
Brampton.
From Brampton. North of Toronto.
Let's hear it.
Couple generations later, and still we ain't formers want to get the funds.
Oh, he's won a cipher. It's many. Oh, Cook and Soul is a Grammy Award winning producer.
Keep the teens asleep behind the wheel. Send for Satan for the sensation. The greater information got you information.
I love
this. Trips, the dope that made the scale trip to polo sailing, grinding like my border top, some kind of railing, pound of marijuana.
It's good.
Yeah, skunky that come
rap like kind of like old school. Yeah, yeah.
You learning as lessons from earner from.
Gotta be honest, I was ready for a trap kind of thing.
Like nab or something.
I was ready for something like that. This is nice. This is refreshing. Funny enough, this is refreshing.
Yeah.
Hearing like old school boom bap.
I'd love to just picture him in Brampton going to all the different Tim Hortons there. It's funny listening to someone like so hardcore, but then it's like... You live in Brampton. I live my life in extravagance. What the hell?
Brampton's a pretty rough place. The wickedest.
Yeah, true.
I've never been.
Kids get shocked enough, right?
Oh, there you go.
I've been shows
about
there.
Your comments now. It's Brampton.
Happy about your comments now? Shut the fuck up.
The things we go through to become a man. Shit ain't been the same. This is another guy.
Cook and Soul and Raz
Hey!
And the God Fahim.
So that's awesome. Their album cover is a tip of the hat to the Cool Kids.
Cool.
Cool Kids is one of my favorite rap groups, and this is the Bake Sale. Is there in
Bake and Soul?
They're parodying the thing. There you go.
Very coolness.
A fan of Cool Kids is a fan of mine. I really like that. That guy was he's got skills. I think it was two guys, right?
Yes, the God Fahim, Raz Fresco, and producer Cook and Soul, who is a Grammy Award-winning producer and DJ.
That was really great.
Amazing. I love that, David. Yeah. Keep bringing in local people.
It's fun.
It's up to the listeners. You guys got to send me in stuff. Anything you're listening to, local, Canadian. Not local, but Canadian. Canadian. Send it in.
Keep it Canadian. That was awesome. That was really
cool. Did they... Who brought you that?
Fiza.
Oh, very cool.
Fiza knows a ton of hip hop.
Oh yeah, tons of music. She knows a lot of music.
Yeah, she's just intelligent. Seems smart. Seems fucking smart. I'll tell you that much.
You're weird.
No, not weird.
Yeah, she seems intelligent.
No, it just seems like she knows a lot about a lot. You know what I mean?
Yeah. Let's get into our bands.
What? It's true.
Yeah.
Let's get into our bands.
Have you heard her speak about shit?
She's intelligent for a woman.
She's like about 15 years old, and she knows more than me. I'm about four times her age.
Mm-hmm. Mm.
Ugh, cut this, Kyle.
Yeah.
Cut this.
Yeah. All right. Should we get into the band?
You're so annoying, Sam.
Why am I annoying?
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
No.
You're getting mad at me because I'm not even trying to be a dick now. And he's getting pissed.
Yeah, it's because I had a sip of beer.
He's like, you're being a dick right now.
Oh, he has a drink? Oh, my goodness.
What? Yeah, we're having a beer. It's summer.
This is the first?
Yeah. Not bad, eh?
What? It better not be a habit.
Oh, no.
Whoa.
Coming to the fucking
Mama Dave.
Drunk?
Brother.
We come here to work, and you guys come here fucking loaded off.
Oh, it's a party.
Six beers?
Dude, you take bull testosterone every morning. Beers.
I don't take shit. This is
my first ultra.
Yeah. I'm about a third into my first ultra.
Because I only brought two ultras.
Yeah.
What's ultra? French?
No.
It is. It's Michelob. Michelob Ultra. It's the beer of the NBA.
Very cool. I want to say, before we get into our bands,
yeah,
please consider signing up for our Patreon.
Please.
That's where you can get the battles with the music.
Yeah.
You can hear all the songs that we create. Maybe we'll throw that Trap in the Closet riff at the beginning.
100%.
As a track that we'll put on.
That you can listen to whenever you want. And you can, watch and listen to the songs.
Yes.
You could see us react to them.
And it's not a lot of money.
It's really not.
But it really does change everything for us. We would get better equipment. We'll put that money towards different, maybe a studio space in the future, which we're really excited about.
Yes, you'll see more of that.
So please consider, and we love you just for listening, even the free episodes.
Even the
thank
free
you for
ones,
listening.
Thank you.
But consider even fine.
Oh, before we go any further here, I have two stories, quick stories,
please,
of fan interactions that I've...
Wow.
The Taste of Little Italy. I was actually... I can't believe I forgot. This was the Taste of Little Italy. I was walking down the street. I was walking home. Maybe, honestly, one of the drunkest people I've ever seen in my life.
Cool.
He was standing out front, like, barely smoking a cigarette. He's just like, hey, Sam Burns? I was like, oh, hey. He's like, Battle of the Bands. I love it.
Wow.
He's like, it's my favorite podcast. And he's like, yeah, I've told all my friends about it. And all of his friends were like out somewhere else. And he's just by himself, like hanging off a street pole. Yeah, man.
Oh, that's nice.
I was like, oh, thanks, buddy. He's like, where are you going? I'm like, I'm going home. All right. So that was nice.
That's amazing. I love that guy.
And then literally today, there was a guy on Rossi walking his old dog. It was an old pug.
Cool.
But there was a towel wrapped under the pug's belly, and he was holding it up like that. Cause I guess
like it's a bag.
Its hips were all fucked up. And then I see the guy, I see the pug, and I go, ah, like I make a noise like that. And then he looks at me and goes, Sam Burns? And I go, yeah. And he's like, you're a very funny man. He's like, I like what you put out into the world and with the podcast and the comedy and stuff.
Wow.
Like, that's very sweet.
Wow.
Thank you.
Oh.
So there we go.
Moving in the right direction.
Fans. We love you guys.
That is very nice.
Yep. A very drunk guy and a guy walking a 16-year-old pug with a towel.
Range.
Yeah. A very drunk guy and a very sobering man.
So guys, men. Yeah, men love us.
Well, you know what? I will say I was working one day and a girl, she had an Evil Men t-shirt on. And I went, hey, nice shirt. And she went, are you Kyle? And I went, yes. And she went, you're funny.
Nice.
But she didn't say podcast.
She didn't mention
Whoa.
It.
But I feel like she's in pod. She would know podcast because of Evil Men t-shirt.
Okay, interesting.
So kind of nice.
So thank you.
Wonderful.
It is cool. It's very nice. Let's get into the bands.
You are sweating.
Dude, I'm so hot.
Yeah. Really?
There's no air.
Maybe it's because I'm sitting over.
He says really. Really.
Maybe it's because I'm sitting over here. I don't feel it as much.
So hot. And you're hot, right, David?
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay, let's get into the bands.
Okay.
Eric, I'm going to go first because you went first last time.
Yes.
Nah.
Yes, please.
Nah, nah, boo, boo. You can't touch me.
I'm just going to pull up my band. My band this week is one of my favorite bands ever, I would say. At least within the past decade.
Okay.
They are called Mom Jeans.
Okay, and that's what you wear, right?
I wear Mom Jeans sometimes, yes. Yes, sometimes. Yes. Okay. Mom Jeans is an American alternative rock indie band from Berkeley, California. Formed in 2014. What do you think of that?
Very cool. Berkeley. A lot of good music from California.
Yes. Yes, we love Berkeley. Mom Jeans found their start in early 2014 at Berkeley with drummer Austin and lead singer Eric Butler. The duo recorded spring demo in May. Anyways, all this shit here. That's not very professional of me to say. I heard their first album, though. I want to say COVID time, like the beginning of COVID. So,
wow.
Yeah, and it was called Best Buds. And I do think that's kind of their, what's the right word for that? Critically acclaimed? Like, that's, I don't know. To me, at least, that's like their big album. And yeah, I just love their style. It's pop punky, kind of folky sometimes, catchy music. And yeah, and their one song, the Scott Pilgrim versus My GPA, was my most listened to song of 2023, I want to say.
Wow.
I think it was 2023, yeah. And I brought it today, so.
Amazing.
Yeah, yeah, I like these guys a lot.
I also love my band that I picked. This guy is named Drug Dealer.
Huh?
I know. His name is Michael Collins, and he has some great music. He also is a little bit insecure about his voice, so a lot of his songs feature collaborators that sing the songs for him, like Wise Blood, as well as Jackson McIntosh, Sasha Wynn. These people, he has a lot of people that he collaborates with, but he is such a talented musician that he makes such beautiful music. And a couple of his songs I listen to so much, and I really think that you're going to like it.
Okay, cool.
It's funky. It's cool. I wish I knew a little bit more about him, but he is also kind of a newer artist in the sense that his debut of the band is 2016, The End of Comedy.
Oh, yeah?
That's the name it's called. Of it? Yeah, yeah.
Oh, cool.
So, yeah, I'm really excited for you to hear it, and I don't really have much else to say. Let the music speak for itself. That's what I say.
Let's battle!
And those are our songs, and we are back. We just listened to music. Yes.
I'm a different person now.
I am changed. I used to be old Kyle, and now I'm call pre me and K.
Post. I'm pre and post those three rounds there.
I got to say, I like Mom Jeans.
Yeah,
I like Mom Jeans. Good vibes.
I guess I love Drug Dealer.
Great.
I love Drug Dealer, and the band ain't bad either.
Yes, you have sweat in your eyes.
So hot in here, buddy.
Don't worry, we are only here for a temporary time.
Yes. All right, so I'm happy with my choices. I thought yours were great.
Yes.
And
I'm excited to see what David AI thinks.
All right, so starting off with Sam. Sam brought Mom Jeans for a song. November. I don't like the singer Mom Jeans and his voice. Now he sounds like a bit like sometimes Panic at the Disco.
Sorry. Sorry to interrupt. Can you believe we're doing a podcast? That we've been doing a podcast for the last year?
Yeah.
Anyway.
What? That just hit you?
Yeah, I just had an epiphany.
Yeah.
Just sitting here, listening to him talk. Yes. Wait.
It's not the long. Hell?
What?
Dude, how do I start talking and then you have these epiphanies come out of nowhere?
You bring something out of them.
Yeah, boring. Yeah, boring, babe. I like when he talk because he funny, he make me laugh.
Yeah, because I, well, to talk like from the beginning, I'm broken inside, so that made me funny.
Well, David's broken.
I think I need like more than 5 fucking seconds to get my point across, Kyle.
Yes, sire.
Well, he is
ADD, I just can't believe
right?
it.
Yeah, it's amazing.
Stop Are you sure at my that's crotch, bro.
Is that keys? It looks like you have big balls.
Looks like you have one big left testicle.
It's a bumpy pocket.
I feel bad for you.
Looks like a dog toy in there.
Dude, it's my wallet. My pockets lean.
Big ribeye.
Oh my god! You see, I can't even get my fucking funny point across because you're always interrupting me.
Point across. I can't get my funny point across.
My funny point.
Yeah. What's your funny point, asshole?
If there was more air in this room, maybe I would get more animated, but I literally cannot breathe.
Yeah, dude, it's bad in here. All right, give us the fucking hit us.
What were you saying about that? You don't like the singer Mom Jeans?
Sure, I'll entertain you right now, Kyle. All right, November, first song. Yeah, he sounds like he sings like Panic at the Disco, and don't like it.
Don't like it.
I don't like his voice. Great music, great lyrics, though. And the switch up was nice. 7 out of 10.
Nice.
Okay. What did you think of mine?
Tug me.
First song from drug dealer Madison.
Thank you.
Feel like I'm in a jazz bar. I'm staring across at a woman, and I walk up to her. I get her number.
Okay. Yes.
And we go on a coffee date a few days
later. Coffee
date.
Okay.
And then I absolutely blow it. Damn it. 6.5 out of 10.
6.5.
Second song from Mom Jeans, White Trash Millionaire. Pop punk that stays up the whole time and like punchy, I find just as boring as a guy just playing a piano.
Yeah, yeah.
And this is a pretty much.
I'm with you on that one.
I'm not a huge fan of Mom Jeans or like Green Day, for example.
Right.
Yeah. That. Your enemy.
I like how the guitar kind of sounds like a saxophone, though. And it's good breakup music. 6 out of 10.
6 out of 10. Not bad. Okay.
Second song from drug dealer, Pictures of You. So yes. You've blown the coffee date, but she hits you up 5 years later.
Five years.
She's desperate. Yes. She's lonely, and she's hitting up every guy that's shown interest in the past 10 years.
A slut.
So now.
Promiscuous.
Now you're in charge.
Promiscuous.
Now you're in charge. Interesting. Yes.
Boy. Are you smooth? Smooth like the guitar in that song. 7 out of 10.
Damn! Yeah. I'm in trouble.
And let me guess, you go home with her.
What?
Sorry.
Pardon?
Let me guess. You go for coffee, but that makes you just, you are more energy to have sex.
Pardon?
What?
I'll finish the story in the third
review. Yeah, the third act.
Yes.
Scott Pilgrim versus My GPA, another nice breakup song, Liberating.
Yes.
Liberace.
Bro, if I could just handle my own funny, if I didn't
handle,
fear...
Let him handle his own funny.
Fear you having to step in and fill in the imaginary gaps for me. Maybe I'd be 10 times the star on this podcast that you guys think of I could be.
You're amazing.
Yes.
And I got to be honest.
You literally just said I'm not amazing.
If you were 10 times the star, I'd have to kill you because I'm jealous.
When was that?
Yeah.
When did Kyle say you weren't amazing?
Yeah, you're amazing. I said you were boring.
I think you're having intrusive thoughts.
He says I'm amazing, and then he's just like, you're not funny. You're not entertaining. People don't
I think you're funny.
When does he say that?
He literally just said it right now.
Did you?
No, I think he's funny. I think he's amazing.
He says you're not entertaining me. You're not funny. Kyle, Sam's funny.
Oh,
well, Sam, that's because I look at Sam, he's funny looking.
Well, I'm literally a cartoon character.
Yeah. That's not a cartoon, dude.
Anime.
This is not a cartoon character.
So sweaty right now. I'm so sweaty.
And you're staring into the camera.
What
and you're
if the camera catches that? Sweatiness.
Well, it's fucking...
What did you say?
It's not livable in here.
I live in here.
It's not livable conditions.
Yeah.
All right, hit me with Scott Pilgrim versus my GPA.
8 out of 10.
Wow.
Nice.
So that gives you a 21?
21.
Okay, I'll take it.
All right, honey, last song from Drug Dealers.
Honey.
So you got the girl again after 5 years. You're reconnected and you are... You're smooth. Mm-hmm. You got game.
Nice.
So you meet up with her for another date, though.
Okay.
Shouldn't go wrong.
No, you're positive you've changed, okay?
Okay.
And you're going to charm her ass off, but you're actually more boring and more conversationally anticlimactic 5 years later.
Yikes.
And this is the song that's playing when you're staring into your drink after she dips 30 minutes into the date. 6 out of 10.
Oh,
what did I
agree?
Get?
I agree with that rating. Yeah.
Mm.
Musically, really good.
Yeah,
but just didn't scratch the itch.
Well, to be hugged just like a child. No, you go.
To be
what do you think? So what's my full on?
13 to 19.5.
Oh, so I beat your ass.
Mom Jeans beats drug dealer.
Yeah. Wow.
Sam beats Kyle.
Ha ha!
David AI wins.
Barely.
David AI always wins. This was awesome. Once again, super hot. Can't really think.
Yes, one of the best episodes we've ever done.
This was. I said at the beginning, it's going to be one of the best episodes ever. Yeah. And I think it's up there.
I just say, the fact we do it every week is a testament. And as audience, maybe sometimes we don't have good weeks. And
yeah.
That's fine.
You do something every week, there's going to be weeks where it's not great.
Yeah.
And this is not one of them, though. We did well.
Yes, and I have to say, speaking of every week, I do a show every week, every Tuesday in Toronto at Comedy Bar Cab Space. It's called 5 for 5, and I host it with my friend David.
What?
David in the booth, a different David.
David in the booth, yes.
And we'll see you guys soon, I'm sure, and I hope you're watching Sam's special now, motherfucker.
LMNOP on YouTube. Watch it. It's on YouTube for free, baby. Spent lots of money on it.
It's beautiful, and it's funny.
It looks great. Super proud of it.
I opened, and I hope I didn't bury him.
You did great. So LMNOP, Sam Burns, YouTube. Just get those numbers up.
Subscribe to his YouTube, and please watch.
Yeah, because then
and comment and like.
I guess if I get enough views, then I can book festivals or something.
Then you get Howie Mandel's kiss.
Something good happens. I can do Canada's Got Talent.
Truly, 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 something along the lines of that.
Yeah.
And anyways, you get to be along for the ride.
Yeah. And actually, it's already out. Never mind. Okay, David, what you got?
Show 2nd and 4th Sunday at Winona. Pro Comics is really funny. Please come. And also, please send in local artists.
Yes. Please. We love listening to them. Who's the one today?
Raz Fresco.
Really
Raz Fresco, really cool guy.
Really cool. All right, guys. We love you, and keep on battling.
Keep on battling.
Life's a battle.